Hello, and welcome to episode 23 of Made with Carlene Energy. I'm Carlene, and this is my knitting podcast. It is Saturday, May 21st, 2016, and as usual, I am a couple weeks behind on recording an episode, but that just means I have a lot to show you this time, including some finished objects, which is very exciting. So I hope you all are doing well. I hope you've had a lot of knitting time, and thank you so much for coming by to see what I've been up to. I first want to start with some shout-outs to my podcasting friends. Michael, who co-hosts the Penguin Coffee Clutch podcast, and who is also a very talented designer. He's Apteno Knits on Ravelry. You should really check out his designs. They are super impressive and inspiring. And I totally neglected to mention last episode that he had gifted me a copy of his new pattern called the Quick Gift Drop Stitch Mitts. And thank you so much, Michael. I'm really looking forward to picking out some yarn from my stash to make those with. And then Allison, who is the host of the Yarn Parlor podcast. She is A. Levitt 1 on Ravelry, and she just released a pattern called the Shifted Seam Tank. She sent me a really lovely message on Ravelry. It was really nice. I think I got it Monday or Tuesday morning last week, so it was a really nice surprise to wake up to. And yeah, she just designed this tank top, and she sent me a message that said that she had heard me mention that I really like summer knits that are pretty Edison. Oh my goodness. That's Edison. He's having a moment. Allison had said that she heard me mention that I really like summer knits that have that are simple for the most part, but have some type of interesting design element. So her tank top is, as the pattern says, shifted seam. So instead of having the seams on the sides, they're asymmetrical, and one goes across the front and one goes across the back, and it's just a really cool effect. And it's also a racer back tank top, which I really love. So I was really thrilled to see that design in my library now. So thank you so much, Allison. And I'm definitely living under a rock, because I hadn't realized that she started a podcast back in January, and it's called The Yarn Parlor. It's amazing. You probably already watch it, but I'm so behind on watching new podcasts, and I'm so behind on the ones that have already been on my queue for a long time, and I'm kind of freaking out about it, because I want to see what everybody's up to, and I don't know what I've been doing. Knitting, watching Horace and Pete, catching up on Game of Thrones. I caught up on that this past week. Anyway, I'm rambling. Thank you, other podcasters. Thank you, everybody who's commented on my Instagram lately. I'm Carlene G over there and on Ravelry. So thank you, everybody who has left me comments. It's really nice to keep up with everybody on all platforms. So with that, finished objects, let's talk about the tank top I'm wearing, which I am really pleased with. This is the L.2 tank top by, her name is Lydia Symbol. So let's see, L.2. And I think in my last episode I was almost finished with this. And I finished it that week and blocked it, I think last weekend. I waited a while to block it. I was kind of nervous about the fit before blocking, but blocking is magical, of course, and it stretched really nicely to be a really nice fit. It's got this really cool back detail, and then just a simple slip stitch panel up the front. And I knit it out of Elizabeth Lavold Hempathy, which is a hemp, cotton, and modal blend. And this is the mustard colorway. And I knit it on size 5, US 5 needles, which is what it called for. I got pretty close to gauge with that needle, I think. And yeah, it's a really interesting fit. I mean, this front panel is definitely quite narrow, and I mean, I don't know. I obviously need to wear a tank top under it, which yeah, I'm interested to like experiment with different tanks underneath it. And it's a little sheer. And yeah, so it's a great layering piece. I think it's going to make a cool beach cover up too. And yeah, I was nervous about the fit and just the style of it and the wearability, but I think it is something that I'm going to get some good use out of. I do like it. So yeah, that was exciting to get that off the needles. And then FO number two. There's two this week. Wow. So I started this right after I finished this one, because I wanted to keep that summer knit momentum going. And I had shown, I don't think you guys even, yeah, you didn't see this as a work in progress. I had shown you the yarn for it, which I had bought at my local yarn shop when Shane of the Knitroversion podcast came to visit me. And of course I bought yarn while we were together, because he told me it was okay. So yeah, I bought this collection of patterns by Classic Elite. It's for their Fortuna base, which is what I bought three skeins of to make the top layer of the Frankie pattern. So this is two different tank tops, and then you can wear them by themselves or together. There is a option in the pattern to actually knit them together at the armholes at the end so that they're all one piece. But I think that's silly. Don't you want to be able to take them apart? So I started the top layer. I did the top layer first. It starts with the bottom layer, but they're pretty much the same other than the length. So I started with the Fortuna yarn, and this is the brass colorway. And I have finished the top piece. And it does work really nicely as its own garment. The ruffle came out really nicely. The yarn feels really great. It's comfortable. It's a the Fortuna is a 58% linen, 26% viscose, and 16% cotton blend. And yeah, this is the front, and I think, or is this the front? I don't know. I've been getting confused with that. They are slightly different, but anyway, yeah, it fits really well. I posted a picture of me wearing this on Instagram and got some really lovely comments, so thank you for that. And I know it's really going to work in my wardrobe, so it's super exciting. And I did use US size 5 for this as well, which is what is called for. And I guess that's a good segue into works in progress, since I am working on the bottom layer now of the Frankie pattern. So, this has been so nice to work on. This yarn is insane. It's sparkly. It's so pretty. So this is Blue Heron Yarns. Really nice label. This is the rayon metallic base, which is 550 yards of, yeah, rayon. So it's completely synthetic. But this yarn, it's, the feel of it is amazing. I mean, it feels like a liquid, if that makes any sense. It's so drapey and fluid, and it just kind of slides. I mean, I think it's going to be really, really nice to wear. It feels so comfortable. And I was really, the main reason I started with the top layer of the pattern was because I really wanted to knit with this yarn, but I loved it so much in the skein that I was afraid to cake it up. I mean, it's gorgeous in the cake too. It's just one of those magical materials that you're almost afraid to use, but then when you start using it, you're like, oh. Yeah, I don't know. I really love it. It's one of those yarns you just get weird about. And it's really, I mean, you're not really getting the full sense of it. It is slightly tonal, so it's such a light green and kind of creamy. color. It's so hard to describe. The colorway is Celadon, if I didn't say that. So very, very light green, but almost a, it's more of a neutral than a green, but it does have a slight tonal, which is even hard to see in person. It really takes the right light to see that it's not just a solid base behind the metallic. It's actually a variegated yarn as well. So it's super beautiful. I love the fabric it's creating. I'm using the US Fives for this layer as well. I was getting pretty good gauge with that. I am interested to see how, if anyone has any advice or experience knitting with rayon and you know how it wears and how if it stretches, stuff like that, do let me know. Shoot me a comment either on YouTube or on Ravelry. In the Made with Carly Energy podcast group. But yeah, I'm interested to see how it wears. I've got a really lovely stitch marker on here. It's a little pink seed bead enclosed ring marker. I really love these with the beads. And my new friend Nikki gave this to me last weekend when we met up. The New York Knit Nerds met up in Prospect Park in Brooklyn. It was a send-off for Jenny and Devin of the Tiny Paper Foxes podcast because they are moving to Vermont, so they are moving further away from where I am, and it was bittersweet, but it was such a nice meetup, and Nikki and her husband Scott came. I'm going to go into this tangent for now, but so Nikki and Scott came. It was their first time meeting up with us. They've been in Brooklyn for a little bit for Nikki's med school education, which is awesome. She's doing rotations right now. I think that's what it's called. I'm so sorry, Nikki, if I'm butchering this explanation. But anyway, it was really nice that you guys joined us. And we went to Argyle Yarn Shop afterwards. And Nikki's husband, Scott, bought some yarn because he is learning how to knit. So yeah, that's awesome. And yeah, Nikki brought us all little sets of these beautiful stitch markers. So that was such a sweet thing to do and to have a nice memory with my markers of the day. So thank you, Nikki. So yeah, that's just been such a nice project. It's really a lot of stockinette, but I'm not bored with it at all because the yarn is so nice. Keeping it in this bag. My parents got me this bag when I first started knitting. And I don't know who made it. The only label on it says Made in China. But it is really cute. And yeah, it coordinated nicely with this project. And let's see. What's next? I have been working a little bit on this thing. This cowl that I started back in the fall. And it's kind of been hibernating on and off. But I have picked this up a little bit. Where's my marker on it? I mean, it doesn't look like I did anything. I guess several months ago when I put this marker on, the last time I showed it to you, so I've only made it another inch, but at least I've picked it up and added a few rows here and there. It's a good traveling project. This is the White Caps Cowl by Pearl Soho. And it's mostly stockinette, but you're using these funky yarns, so you get this cool texture. The weird greenish color is Habu Textiles Naramaki Slub, which is a cotton slub yarn. It's thick and thin. This is what it looks like. And then that's the khaki colorway. And then the cream color is Alchemy Yarns Silk and Straw. It's 100% silk, and it's kind of this flat, flat strand of silk, and it's kind of crunchy, but it'll soften up after I wash it. So they're both really fun to work with. They're so interesting. So yeah, I've been picking that up here and there. It's a nice spring cowl, so I wish I could wear it, but at the same time, I'm not in any rush to have it. It's just not one of those things I feel like must finish. Yes, I have some tea. Okay, I'm getting distracted by all of the rest of this stuff. I guess I'll talk about my Luca shawl because I have been working on it a lot. In my last episode, I was here. So over the last 2 weeks, I finished chart C, which was the last chart of the main body pattern. And then I had one more increase section, which is all these eyelets here. And then a couple rows of stockinette. And I have started the applied border. And I am a whopping 3 repeats into it. I just started the applied border today when I woke up this morning. So yeah, it's going well so far. It's definitely turning out to be the pattern that it looks like in the photos, so that's encouraging. It's my first applied border, so I was kind of nervous to start it, but it's going okay so far. It feels like it's going to take forever. So I've been hosting, this is the Luca shawl by Jared Flood in the most recent Brooklyn Tweed collection, winter 2016. And I am using the yarn called for, which is Plains by Brooklyn Tweed. It's their small batch lace weight yarn in the Scarab colorway. Blah, blah, blah. I've been co-hosting a knit along for this shawl with Gabby of the Once Upon a Corgi podcast and Denise of the Yarn Geek podcast, who are two of my good podcasting friends that I get to meet up with in New York City once in a while. And we've been hosting this since March, so the start date was March 1st, and we've had some really lovely participants who have finished their shawls, which is amazing. Congratulations. It's really exciting to see some finished ones come out of the knit along, so I'm really hoping I can get myself to get through this border in the next, I have like 10 days to do it, or less than that. I have like a week to do it before the end of the cowl, which is May 30th or 31st. Are there 31 days in May? May 31st is the end of the knit along. So I'm hoping then the next week that I can finish this up. It's been really, really nice to work on. I think I'm gonna love the finished project or product. It's my first really major lace weight thing, so that's really exciting. And it's my first pie shawl, so yeah, it's been a pretty intense project. But I think when I block it, it's going to be quite stunning. I love this color. I'm excited to mix this color in with the rest of my wardrobe. So yeah, if you are working on a Luca shawl for the knit along, I hope that you are at the border or close to it. And yeah, it's been really nice to see everybody's progress. I'll put that in the bag later. So, what else? I'm trying to make sure I'm not missing anything. Before I move on, I have swatched for a new project. I have the pattern down here. So I showed the yarn for this in my last episode, I think. I had just gotten it. I got this from my local yarn shop, which is Black Sheep Yarns in Kent, Connecticut. I have been looking at this Ito, the Japanese brand. This is their Kinu base. And it's 100% silk. And it's this tweedy, very light. I mean, it's almost lace weight. It's a very, very light fingering. Basically a waist lace weight, I guess. It's really interesting and tweedy. This is the cream colorway. But it's kind of rosy pink. It's coming off quite cream, I guess, on camera, but in person it's definitely a very pale pink, which is another color I've been really into lately. I couldn't help myself. I wanted to swatch for it. I swatched for it after I finished this top layer, and didn't quite want to cast on for the next one yet. So I decided to do a little swatching, and I don't have very much. I think I do want to keep knitting this into a bigger swatch so I can really get a feel for the yarn. It's definitely very interesting to knit with. It feels very delicate, and it's very light, so yeah, my tension, you know, it definitely feels different. Yeah, and I think I'm getting gauge. It is quite a sheer fabric, but I'm using, this is a US 3, so 3.25 millimeters, and I'm swatching with this for the, I guess you pronounce this Hane, because it's Japanese. It's Japanese for, what does it say? I think Hane, it's Japanese for feather, plume, or wing. So it's named for the little ruffle detail on the shoulder. And this is by Kirsten Johnstone. I've been wanting to make this for a while, and it's a really nice pattern because it gives you all these options for the sleeve. So you can do sleeveless, or one ruffle, or no ruffle, t-shirt. So it's a really versatile pattern, and it would be nice to use again to make the different versions. So anyway, yeah, this is what I bought for that. I have two cones of it. And yeah, it was on sale at my local yarn shop because she's moving her shop, so she was having a bit of a moving sale. She's moving to a bigger space, which is amazing. I mean, I'm getting gauge, I think, or at least stitch gauge. I'm gonna wash it. I'm gonna knit a bigger swatch and then wash it to see how it reacts. But yeah, it's definitely an interesting fabric, and I think it will work for the pattern. So that was my little swatching. I've been trying to be good about swatching. I swatched with these yarns for my Frankie tank top. I swatched for this. Trying to not just make things recklessly and have them not fit. It's been working out so far. So I guess that brings me to stash, which there shouldn't be any stash, but there is. I guess first of all, I'll show you this stuff which I've had. This is what I'm thinking I might try to use for Allison's shifted seam tank that she gifted me. So I have this weird worsted weight kind of ribbony cotton nylon yarn that was gifted to me by one of my coworkers. She gave me this huge bag of yarn, and it was a lot of novelty stuff, but like nice novelty stuff. So this is one of them. It's got this gold border on this kind of cotton knitted ribbon. I gotta look at the yardage. I think I have 3 balls of this. I might have another one lying around somewhere in my closet. This is, I don't even know what this is called. It's Tacky Sade. That's the base. Can you see that? The price tags on this yarn are ridiculous. Some of the stuff that she gave me. So this is... this is what I might use. Sorry, I'm totally spacing out by looking at this label. This is what I might try to use for Allison's shifted seam tank. I have a ball of this as well, which I might do some type of color block thing. I don't know. I'm gonna swatch. This is also kind of a tape yarn. I don't know what the content is. I don't know who made it. I don't have the label, but I have these random kind of cottony novelty yarns that I wanted. Figure out something to do with that I will actually wear. So this will be a bit of a kind of a challenge to myself to see if I can use these and actually, you know, enjoy the result. So I'm going to swatch, see how the color looks together. I do like gray and yellow together. Grello is really cool. So that might be something. I don't know if I have enough of it, so I might have to incorporate more yarns. So anyway, that's another tank top planned. I mean, the tank tops, people, this summer is, just stop looking at Ravelry, because I want to buy another, like, 6 quantities worth for tank top, like, tank quantities worth of yarn. You know, there's sweater quantity, SQ. I'm into the TQs right now, the tank quantities. And, I mean, the new Pom Pom magazine is ridiculous. Don't look at it. You'll want to make everything, or at least I do. It's just really on point with my style right now, and it's breaking my heart with all these patterns. With that said, I have another tank quantity of yarn, because I guess I'll just, I'll go more into Prospect Park again. So last weekend we had our meetup with the knit nerds of New York City and the surrounding areas, and a bunch of the podcasters in this area. We all met up at Prospect Park, like I said, to celebrate with Devin and Jenny one more time before they move. And we had snacks and some drinks, and it was a really, really nice day. The weather held out for us. It was a little breezy and chilly, but it didn't rain while we were still there, so that was good. A little bit of a storm had rolled in that evening, but we were able to have from like 11:30. I got there around 11, quarter to noon. I got a little lost. Devin helped me figure out where the meetup spot was. We just hung out, had our snacks. And you know, it's nice that these things, like, we're all there for knitting, but I don't even know if much knitting happens. I mean, I knit a little bit, but you know, it goes beyond the knitting, which is really cool. And then we took a walk over to Argyle Yarn Shop afterwards, and I told everybody to not let me buy stuff, but you guys are bad at that. and I wasn't going to buy anything. I was so close to being like, all right, we're good. Like, I was kind of planning a lot of things out. There's a lot of tank patterns that I want to make. So I was kind of looking at the prices of yarn and how much I would need for all these different things. And I thought I was really close. I was actually looking for yarn for the shifted seam tank, but I knew that I had stuff that I was trying to maybe use instead. Then I kind of somehow fell in love with some Quince & Co. and got 6 skeins to make another tank top. This is their Willet base, so it's 100% cleaner cotton, which I don't know what the cleaner cotton means. I should have looked that up, but I don't know if you can really read that, but cleaner cotton, the Willet base, and this is the ore colorway, so it's this dusty pinky, peachy, maybe a little peachy. I don't know. It's pink. It's the pink that I am into lately. Usually not a very pink person, but yeah, this color, the dusty faded pinks are really in my life right now. And so this is 160 yards per skein. It's a sport weight, so it calls for US size 5. A lot of tank tops on size 5s lately. And here are my 6 skeins. Oops, guys. Ugh. But there is a plan. There's a plan for them, so it's fine. So another magazine with crazy, ridiculous summer knits right now. I mean, people are just killing it. I mean, it's like, look at this one. This is the Kingston tank. I really want to make this one too. Yeah, that is gorgeous. But with the Quince & Co., I am making the Venice top, which is this one. So it's this kind of eyelet, very flowy body, and it's got this amazing lace panel on the front. And then on the back, it's a little bit different. Yeah, I'm not giving you a very good picture of that. But, that's what I'm making with this. I think it's going to be really nice. So, and the way that I justified this is because I did do, when I was home in New Jersey for Mother's Day, which was really nice. Got to hang out with my mom and my dad, and we, the Saturday before Mother's Day, we spent in Lahaska, Pennsylvania, which is this really nice little quaint shopping village, really beautiful town that we used to actually visit when my brother and I were kids. We would go there on day trips, my family, since it was only about an hour and a half from where we live in New Jersey. So it was a nice drive and a nice place to spend the afternoon. They have nice restaurants and stuff like that. So we went there, and there were some, you know, like fancy clothing boutiques, and I tried some things on because I wanted a few new kind of spring tops to refresh my wardrobe a little bit. And yeah, I mean, I tried some things on that I liked, but they weren't quite right. One shirt that I really liked, and they didn't have the right size for me, and it was like a pale pink color because I want a pale pink camisole type of thing. And yeah, it just didn't work out. And the price on it, compared to what I need in yarn, was about the same. So, I mean, I figure that I was really close to spending the money on that shirt that was pre-made and made in China, and, you know, or I could get the materials to make my own that I know is going to fit right, and I know is going to be well made, and it's going to last me a lot longer, and I'm going to have the satisfaction of I made it myself. So yeah, I wanted a pink shirt, I wanted a pink tank top, so I'm going to make myself a pink tank top. I mean, like, that's awesome. That's such a good feeling to be like, well, yeah, that shirt didn't fit, but I still want it, so I'll just do it myself. So yeah, justification for my yarn purchase. I would have bought the you know, I would have spent the money on a shirt anyway. And a little bit more stash. This is Once Upon a Corgi. So Gabby of Once Upon a Corgi. This is her Audrey base. So it's an 80% superwash blue face Lester and 20% nylon, 400 yards fingering weight. Some good sock yarn right here. And this colorway is, this coffee is making me awesome. And I've been wanting this since she started dyeing it. And she had an update last week or the week before, and just couldn't help myself. Had to snatch it up this time. So yeah, it's kind of like lavenders and all the coffee colors and these, you know, the speckles of awesome. Really, really cool. And I don't know what I'm going to do with it yet. It would be great for socks, but it would be super cool to incorporate into a shawl. So we'll see. And I also got the, I think this is, yeah, issue 4 of Knitwit magazine. If you haven't checked this out, it is a gorgeous magazine. It covers all kinds of textile stuff beyond knitting, weaving. It's hand dyers, natural dyers. It's a really, really lovely magazine. Amazing photographs, really great articles. It's not a pattern. It doesn't have patterns. It's all interviews with the artists and the designers, and just inspiration. So I would definitely check this out if you haven't yet. This is issue 4. So that was their first full like season of issues, and I've really been enjoying it. What else? I feel like I'm forgetting stuff as usual. And it's only been, I thought this would take me a lot longer, to get through. Oh, duh, it's sitting right here. See, I need my visual cues surrounding me. So Nikki, who I mentioned before, made the, stitch markers to gift to us all, at the Brooklyn meetup. She had asked all of us if any of us had made the Tulip Tank Top by Pearl Soho, which came out a few years ago. And I had totally forgotten that I'd made this thing, but as soon as she said the tulip tank, I knew which one she was talking about. And I made this, I knit it, and it's, 2 summers ago, and all I have to do is pick up stitches around the armholes to complete it, because it has this finished edge around the armholes. And I think, because the back is one of those swoopy thing, I don't know what you call this, but it swoops up, so you get this open back type of thing. And I think this gets tacked down somehow when you pick up the armholes, because this is the piece, yeah, that goes across. So I think that gets tacked down somehow. So yeah, I have very little to do to finish this. I have a mess of ends to weave in, of course, as well. But yeah, I made this 2 summers ago. I ran out of yarn, and that's why the top is this variegated. And I totally forgot to bring the label or try to find what yarns these are. This is, I think it's Cascade. No, it's Classic Elite. I think it's Classic Elite Firefly, which is either a hemp or a linen blend. And then I forget what this is. I think it's also a Classic Elite, and it's pretty much the same yarn. It's just they call it something different because it's their kind of variegated, stripey version of it. But anyway, so I ran out of the solid color, and I went to a yarn store that actually did have this in stock in this color, but I didn't want to just get this color and then have it be, a sharp difference because of dye lot. I guess I could have alternated skeins and faded it out and blended it, but I decided to go with the variegated, I did kind of stripe it in, like, did a few rows and then used this again, and then eventually was just using the variegated because the color is very similar. And I decided I didn't like it. I was like, oh, I would have liked it a lot more if it was all just one solid thing, and if the detail was only on the back instead of having a different detail on the front as well. So it's been sitting in a basket, which you can tell because it's all wrinkled. And after Nikki mentioned it, I was like, you know what, I really need to try that on again. I need to reassess whether I like it or if I should rip it out and redo it somehow or just use the yarns for a different tank top. But I tried it on and I think I like it. I think I actually like that there's this kind of front detail and then the back has its own design element. So I think I'm going to finish it. I'm going to figure out those armholes and, then at that point, if I still am kind of on the fence about it, then I can rip it out. But for now, I want to finish it and actually try wearing it. So thank you, Nikki, for reminding me that I have this lying around, because now it's just, you know, it'll be another summer top. I'm really happy with how my summer wardrobe is going as far as handmade pieces, because of course in the winter it's so much easier to incorporate things, but I feel like I'm definitely starting to have just as nice of a summer collection, so it's very exciting. Well, I think with that I'm gonna get back to it and work on my Luca shawl some more. I'm probably forgetting a bunch of things as usual, but I'll just get to those next time. I have been spinning here and there on my drop spindles, nothing really to show, just some samples, and every once in a while I pick up a spindle and spin for, you know, 10 minutes. Still have a braid on my wheel that needs to be, or a ball of yarn on my wheel that just needs to be plied. But it's still in the same state. I really need to work on that. I hope you all are having a nice weekend. And thank you so much for watching. I will see you on Instagram and Ravelry. Happy knitting. And I'll catch you next time.